Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Blender tutorial. Last time we were looking at all of the extrude tools in Blender 4.5, but we skipped over one which is called the spin tool, which I just want to talk about in a separate video. So today I'm going to be showing you how to do it to turn just a simple plane into a shape like this. And it's a super handy tool for all sorts of applications, so it's definitely one worth learning. So I'm going to go ahead and go back into object mode just now, just to be the same as you. And I'll just left click and press X to delete this object. Now I'll press Shift and then A, and we'll go ahead and start off with maybe a plane shape, and then I'm going to press tab to go into edit mode and press A to select everything. And we need to come down to this option here called spin, and this is going to allow you to use this tool. Now, right now, you can see it's already given us an option to start spinning, and you can see we can choose a few different options. We can change it based on the axis. So for now, I'll show you how it works on the Y axis. Just leave it like that. If I left click this plus symbol here, you can see it's going to start rotating around like this and creating a little bit of a really poor geometry looking cylinder. So I'll press Ctrl Z to undo that. And what I'm going to do first is press G and then X to go ahead and move this. Now, what's exactly happening here is we're moving this face away from this center line here, because this spin tool is going to be using this 3D cursor. You'll notice if I press Shift right click to move this 3D cursor that the spin tool also moves with it. By the way, if you accidentally move your cursor around, you can hold down the Shift key and then press S to open up this cursor menu. And you can just choose cursor to world origin. Or if your object is somewhere in 3D space here, you can come back into object mode by pressing tab, hold down the Shift key and the S key, and this time choose cursor to selected, because your origin should be in the center of your object here. So I'll press tab to come back into edit mode. And now when I left click and drag the spin option, you can see we can go all the way around like this, and it's a pretty damn cool tool. So that's essentially how it works. If I press Ctrl Z to undo that, and I can press R and then maybe X and choose the number 90 to rotate 90 degrees, we can also use one of the other axes. So if I use Z, for example, now we can spin this way, which is pretty cool. And there is also a hotkey for it as well. If I come up to the top here and go to the normal select mode, I can hold down Alt and then press E to open the extrude menu, since this is technically a kind of extrude, and we can choose the spin option. And you can see this works a little bit differently. It's gone ahead and done that. It uses this menu here to determine how it works. So you can see I've got the number of steps, which is just how many times it's spinning. And you can see the axes is a little bit messed up. So I'm just going to maybe change this all to zero. And if we wanted it to work around the Z axis, we could go ahead and maybe change it to 90 like that. And there we go. It's now working around there. And we can also adjust the angle to change how far it's going. And also, if you want to change the direction, because I think it's going the other direction, you can press minus. And maybe I'll change it to something like minus 90, just so we can see it. So a little bit more of a complicated tool, but you can use it with a hotkey as well, if need be. So yeah, that pretty much covers how to use the spin tool. Hope you found it useful, and I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.